This tutorial is going to cover Java application security on a Tomcat 7 web server. And specifically, it's going to cover basic authentication. So I'm going to start by writing a servlet that all what it does is return a simple string if it was successfully accessed, and a web.xml where the following is defined: a role that users trying to access the servlet must belong to, and a basic authentication mechanism that is specified in that web.xml file. And in the Tomcat users.xml file, I'm gonna go ahead and set up a user with a username and a password and belonging to the role that was specified in the web.xml file. And the last thing I'm gonna do is to test run the web application. Start by creating a new project. And I'm going to call it Java Web Security Project 02. And it's going to run on Tomcat 7. And it's going to have a web.xml file. And here I'm going to create a new servlet that's going to be in the package com.za.tutorial. And I'm gonna call this servlet do something servlet. And it's only gonna have a doGet method. Now this servlet is gonna be returning HTML contents. So I'll pick up a printwriter instance using response.getWriter and call the println method on it. And it's just gonna return this string saying success. And let me go ahead and clean up the code here. Going to the web.xml, let me start, since I'm gonna be using basic authentication, just gonna specify that, and I'm gonna do it with the login config tag, and the auth method is gonna be basic. And I want to associate the servlet URL with a role. So under the security constraint tag, I'm gonna specify a web resource collection for this URL pattern, for the URL that the servlet URL. And I'm gonna associate that with users under the role name of users. So for this auth constraint tag, next to get the servers directory, under the project explorer. I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna try to run it, even though I haven't yet modified the Tomcat users file. So here we go, so now I have the servers directory. Let me cancel out from here for now. And I'm gonna go ahead and modify the Tomcat users.xml file. So I'm gonna go ahead and specify the users role. So I'm gonna have a role name of users. And I'm gonna go ahead and add a user that belongs to this role name. So the password I'm gonna have is password, and the username I'm gonna call it ZA user. And the role is gonna be the user's role. So the ZA user is gonna be under the user's role. Now let me go to the do something servlet and try to run it. And here I'm gonna try to log in under the ZA user name with the password password. And here we go. So I got success.